Hi friends, welcome to my YouTube channel Literature Insights, an easy platform to learn English language and literatures in English. If you have not subscribed my YouTube channel Literature Insights yet, so please subscribe it by pressing the bell icon for getting further notifications and updates of my coming videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon before watching this video. So in this video, I am going to discuss with you some of the most important 20 MCQs on phonetics that covers the topic of introduction to phonetics and organs of speech. Along with organs of speech, there are three significant systems of organs of speech, such as the respiratory system, the phonatory system and the articulatory system. So this video will be helpful for the students of English optional in preparation of their final year examination. The nature of these MCQs, each MCQ having 2 marks, so it carries total 40 marks. So students should be ready to judge how he will score in this examination of MCQs. So here the students have to ready to answer each questions on the basis of their study and knowledge. Here I read first questions and then I will read 4 options of each questions. After reading 4 options, I will answer the correct option of each questions in the video. So watch it carefully. It will helpful in a preparation of final year examination. So let's see MCQs on phonetics. Video deals with important MCQs on modern English structure phonetics that deals with 2 significant topics from phonetics, introduction to phonetics and organs of speech. On the basis of these 2 topics, here I have prepared 20 MCQs on phonetics that will be helpful for the students of English optional in preparation of their final year examination. So let's study the 20 MCQs on phonetics with carefully. So now here the first question is, phonetics is a branch of. Here are 4 options: A. Linguistics, B. Writing, C. Reading, D. None of the above. And the correct option is linguistics. Phonetics is a branch of linguistics. Question number 2. IPA stands for. The 4 options are: A. International Phonetic Association, B. International Phonetic Alphabet, C. International Phonetic Assembly, D. International Phonetic Agenda. And the correct option is International Phonetic Alphabet. The International Phonetic Alphabet was invented in 1888 in England to show the corresponding relationship between speech sounds. Question number 3. Phonetics is a systematic study of. And here are 4 options again: A. Human, B. Speech, C. Sound, D. All the above. And the correct option of this question is D. All the above. Phonetics is a systematic study of human speech sounds. Then question number 4. There are 3 branches of phonetics. So what are the branches of phonetics? So now here 4 options: A. Articulatory phonetics, B. Acoustic phonetics, C. Auditory phonetics, D. All the above. And the correct option is all the above. There are 3 branches of phonetics, such as articulatory phonetics, acoustic phonetics and auditory phonetics. Question number 5. A phoneme is the unit of in a speech. Now here are 4 options: A. Sound, B. Symbol, C. System, D. None of the above. And the correct option is A. Sound. A phoneme is the smallest unit of sound in a speech. Then question number 6. How many sounds in phonetics? Here are 4 options: A. 20, B. 24, C. 12, D. 44. And the correct answer is D. 44. There are 44 sounds in phonetics. Then question number 7. There are vowels. So here are 4 options: A. 22, B. 20, C. 24 and D. 44. And the correct option is B. 20. There are 20 vowels.
Question number 8. There are monophthongs. So how many monophthongs in vowel? So now here four options again. A 10, B 12, C 8, D 24. And the correct option is B 12. There are 12 monophthongs in vowel. Question number 9. There are diphthongs. How many diphthongs in vowel? So now here four options. A 12, B 8, C 20, D 24. And the correct option is B 8. So there are 8 diphthongs in vowels. So basically we know that the vowels are divided into two parts, monophthongs and diphthongs. Monophthongs means single vowel and diphthongs means double vowel. Then now here the question number 10, diphthong means vowel, and the four option is here: A double vowel, B single vowel, C triple vowel, D none of the above. And the correct option is A double vowel. Diphthong means double vowel. Question number 11. The organs of the human body which produce speech sounds are together called. The four options: A phonetics, B phonology, C organs of speech, D language. What will be the correct answer of this question? And the correct answer is organs of speech. In articulation or production of speech sounds, we are using the organs of our body, such as the lips, the tongue, the teeth, the nose, the nasal cavity, oral cavity, the alveolar ridge, the hard palate, soft palate, the vocal cords, the larynx, pharynx, the lungs. So these are the important organs of the human body which are helpful in the production or articulation of speech sounds are called organs of speech. Then question number 12. The organs of speech and their speech functioning can be described under three systems. So now here the four options: the respiratory system, the phonatory system, C the articulatory system, D all the above. And the correct option is D all the above. The organs of speech and their speech functions can be described under three systems, such as the respiratory system, the phonatory system, and the articulatory system. Then question number 13. The respiratory system comprises. Here are four options: A the lungs, B muscles of the chest, C the windpipe, D all the above. And the correct option is D all the above. The respiratory system comprises of the lungs, muscles of the chest, and the windpipe. The respiratory system means breathing system. So these three organs are very significant in a respiration or a breathing system. Question number 14. The larynx is situated at the top of the. Here four options again: A windpipe, B vocal cords, C vowla, D lungs. And the correct option is windpipe or trachea. The larynx is situated upper part of the trachea or windpipe. Question number 15. The wide opening space between the vocal cords is called. A the larynx, B the pharynx, C glottis, D trachea. And the correct option is C glottis. The wide opening space between the vocal cords is called glottis. Then 16. All the body parts that we use to produce speech sounds are called. A the respiratory system, B the phonatory system, C the articulatory system, D all of the above. And the correct option is the articulatory system. All the human body parts that we use to produce or articulate speech sounds are called the articulators. Then question number 17. F, F, Th, and the consonants are produced with the help of. So which organ is used in the production or articulation of these speech sounds? So now here is a four options: A the lips, B the teeth, C the tongue, D the hard palate. And the correct option is B the teeth. While production of F, V, Th, and the consonants, we are using the teeth. Question number 18. The soft palate is also called. A the larynx, B the hard palate, C the velum, D, the pharynx. And the correct option is C, the velum. Question number 19. There are three different parts of the tongue. A, the tip of the tongue. B, the blade of the tongue. C, back of the tongue. D, all of the above. And the correct option is all of the above. So there are three significant parts of the tongue, such as the tip of the tongue, the blade of the tongue, back of the tongue, that are used in the production or articulation of speech sounds. Then question number 20. The alveolar ridge is also called A, the soft palate, B, the vowela, C, the teeth ridge, D, the nasal cavity, and the correct option is C, the teeth ridge. So in this way we have seen 20 MCQs on introduction to phonetics and the organs of speech.
Here in this video I have discussed 20 MCQs along with 4 options. These MCQs covers the main topics of phonetics like introduction to phonetics and organs of speech that will be helpful in preparation of examination of the students. So I hope you like my videos on MCQs on phonetics. If you like, please share, subscribe my YouTube channel Literature Insights among your friends, Fraternity of Language and Literature.